Hi, this is Venkat Narayana from Shunya Technologies. Today I am going to discuss do while loop in C. This is continuation to previous video, part 16, while loop in C. Please go through previous video before going through this video. Here syntax for do while loop. First step is assignment. Later we have do block. Do block contains statements. Statements will execute. Later variable will be increment or decrement. Later we have while and check the condition. If condition is true, then re-execute the do block. If condition is false, it will exit from do while loop. We'll discuss this program over VS Code, launch VS Code and create C application. First step is read input from command prompt, printf, enter input number, declare a variable int input, read the input from command prompt, scanf, percentage d, comma, address of input. Assign the variable int I equal to 1, do. Here we need to write code printf percentage d slash n, comma, I, increment I plus plus. Let us write the condition here, I less than or equal to input. Execute this code, control F5, we are getting error. Go to problems, here expected, we forget to mention semicolon, control F5, enter input number 5, enter. We are getting output as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we will discuss how to execute code in debug mode. Put breakpoint here. Go to run. Click on start debugging or F5. Later click step into or F11. Click on start debugging. F11. Read input. Your input is 3. Enter. Here I is equal to 1. First we will execute do block, later we will check the condition. First we are printing I is equal to 1, here it is printed. Later I increment to 1, I is equal to 2. Here I is equal to 2, 2 less than or equal to 3, true. This condition is true, then re-execute do block. Here I is equal to 2, print 2. Later I increment to 1, I is equal to 3. Here 3 less than or equal to 3, true. Then re-execute do block, here print 3, I increment 1, I is equal to 4, 4 less than or equal to 3, false, it exits from do while. What is happening in do while loop? First it will not check the condition, it will execute the do block, later it will check the condition. That means if the condition is true or false, it will execute at least one time. We'll debug one more time, go to run. Click on start debugging, F11, here we will provide input as 0, enter, print I is equal to 1, here first we are printing the output, here I is equal to 1, print, now I increment 1, I is equal to 2, later I is equal to 2, 2 less than or equal to 0, false, it exits from while loop. That means here we provide input as 0, but it is executing one time. Here we will comment increment, we will debug the code, go to run, click on start debugging, F11, read input, here 3, enter, int I is equal to 1, print I is equal to 1, later 1 less than or equal to 3, true. Now do block is executing. Print I, here 1 printed, we are not incrementing the I value, all the times I is equal to 1. So here this condition is true every time, re-execute in do block, it will continue infinite times. So here it is printing 1111, please stop execution. So if we forget to mention increment or decrement in do block, then do while loop will execute infinite times. We'll check one more program. Uncomment this one. Ctrl K, Ctrl U. Remove this condition and put 1. In C, if we mention other than 0, then that condition is true. Here we mention 1. That means all the time while loop is true. We'll debug the code. Go to run. Click on start debugging. F11. Read input here. 3. Enter. Int I is equal to 1. Here print 1. Later I increment 1. I is equal to 2. Then all the time this while condition is true. So this do block will execute infinite times. Here it's printing like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 up to infinite times. Control that. I change back to condition. Now we'll see what is the difference between while loop and do while loop. Here I will create while loop. Int j equal to 1. While condition j less than or equal to input. Here remove this code. Printf. While percentage d slash n comma j j plus plus. Now I'll execute this program. Go to run, click on start debugging. F11, read input. Here I'll provide input as 0. Enter. Here j is equal to 1, 1 less than or equal to 0. False. It exits from while loop. That means this while loop will not execute. But if you go to do while loop, here int I is equal to 1, input is equal to 0. But we are printing I is equal to 1, later I increment 1, now I is equal to 2. So finally we are checking condition. Here I is equal to 2, 2 less than or equal to 0. False. Then it will exit from do while. Here we are printing output as 1. In while loop, if condition is true, then this block will not execute. But in do while loop, first do block will execute, later it will check the condition. So if the condition true or false, both times this block will execute at least one time. When you use while loop and do while loop, for example, consider Google Pay. If you create Google Pay account first time, if you do the transaction or not, first time you'll get the gift voucher. So at that scenarios, we'll use do while loop. If you use do while loop, once we create account, so we'll get the gift voucher. Later, if you do one more transaction, then we'll get one more gift voucher. Now, if you see how to use while loop. So already we have Google Pay account. Now, if you do any transaction, then we'll get the gift voucher. If you don't do transaction, then we'll not get gift voucher. At that scenario, we'll use while loop. In while loop, this condition is true, then this code will execute. If condition is false, this code will not execute. That's it for today. If you like this video, please share with your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel for future videos. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.